Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Minecraft Change Music Disc video, I'll show you how to put your own music onto the different music discs so you can play whatever songs you want in the jukebox. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. You can support my channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every single week, and if you're into graphics programs like Photoshop or Photoshop Elements, I have training courses for that as well, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. The way you normally play a music disc here inside of Minecraft is you first need, of course, a jukebox like I have right back over there, and then you need a music disc. Let's just take this one, kind of yellow disc here, and I'll go over and let's just go ahead and put this one inside of that jukebox there. There we go. You can kind of hear that strange sound. You can change different discs just like that. There we go. Now, as you move away from the jukebox, the sound will begin to fade out. There it goes. It's just beginning to fade out now. Get a bit further away, it just fades out altogether until you can't really hear it. There it is. It's just about gone there. And there we go, it's all faded out and I can't hear the sound any longer. So the sound depends upon how close you are to the sound source. In this case, the sound source, of course, is that jukebox. So I'll show you how to change the sound and also how to make sure that it fades out like that as you move away from the sound source. Just get that out of there. There we go. Okay, let's now switch out of Minecraft and I'll show you how to set this all up. We'll need just a few things to make this project work. First off, you'll need to have a basic custom texture pack slash resource pack set up. Now, if you don't know how to do that, take a look at my video on how to set up a custom texture pack. There's a link for that up there, upper right-hand corner, and I'll also put that link in the description as well. That will give you the assets folder, the pack.mc meta file, and also the pack.png. If you want to, you can just download these three files. I have those in a zip file on my website, and there's a link for that in the description as well. So you need those. The 1.14.4 folder over here, this is the original uncompressed jar file right there. So we don't actually need that. Okay, you also need, of course, to have a piece of music. I have one right here. This is from the YouTube audio library, so it's safe to use here in this video. And it's useful to have this little file here as well. You can download this also from my website, and that's right here. It's simply a list of the music discs in Minecraft. The name of the disc is right down here, the name of the song right there. This is the color on the label. The 13 is colored yellow. And then on the right-hand side over here, this is the actual name that is used inside of the JSON file. And that's what I want to have available for use. We'll change this one down here. It's called Mall. It's the purple disc. And there's the name for that. So we'll be changing that one. Okay, so we have all of our items together. We also need to have some way of editing the sound file, and I'll be using Audacity for that. It's a free download, very powerful program, works out great for working with Minecraft audio. Okay, let's open up the file. I already have mine open right there. And here it is. Now the first thing you'll see right off is that this is a stereo file. And we need this in mono format and not stereo format. If it's in stereo, you won't get that fade out as you move away from the jukebox. In Audacity, we can do that up here where it says tracks, come down to mix, and we'll mix our stereo down to mono right there. And there it is, it's now a mono track. So that's the first half of this, that's easy to do. We now need to have this in the .ogg or .ogg file format for use in Minecraft. So I'll export this out to that format. So file, come down to export, export as .ogg right there. There it is. This is in the same folder. Choose save and OK. And there we go. And take a look over here. There it is. There's the same file in the .ogg format. Okay, that's all we need to do with the audio file. I can now close down that Audacity program. We're done with that one. There it is. So there's our .ogg file in mono. So that's all set to go. Let's now look at our assets folder. Let's open this up and open up where it says Minecraft. And in here, we need to have a folder called Sounds. Now, if you haven't already done this from one of my previous videos, just go ahead and make a Sounds folder. And that's just, you know, new folder and name it Sounds. That's all you have to do. Let's just get rid of that one. Don't need that now. There we are. So here's our Sounds folder. Inside of the Sounds folder, make a folder that says Records, because we're making records. And in here is where we'll place that file. So let's go back and back to our original file here. I'm just going to right-click and copy this. Let's go into our Sounds folder. So it's Minecraft, Sounds, Records, and then right here, we'll paste that in. Okay, now we need to rename this file. That's because Minecraft will only look for these file names over here for the records. So this one is named Mall. So I'll just rename this file. There it is. It's now renamed to match that one. We're working with the purple label. Okay, that's all done. So everything now is done in that assets folder. That's all taken care of. One thing to check in here, if you want to have the name show up properly inside of the inventory list, then let's open this up again, open Minecraft up again, and look for a folder named Lang. Stands for language. Open that one up. You'll see a JSON file in here. You can open this up in any text editor. That's fine. I have mine open up in Notepad. Big messy stuff in here, but that's why we have this file over here. So here's our mall. Let's just grab this name right there. I'll select that, right-click, copy. Go back over to this file, edit, and find. And I'll paste that in right here. Find next, and there we go. There are two of these. There's a second one. So the top one up here is the name of the disk. I'll say music disk. The next one down here, this is the name that shows up inside of Minecraft in the inventory. This can be any name you want. That's fine. This one's actually called Dusty Road. That's the name of the piece. So there we go. Dusty Road. And save. Okay. Now, if you don't happen to have this Lang folder, that's why I still have that 1.14.4 folder over here. You can find them by going into Assets, into Minecraft, and you should see it right there. Just copy the whole folder over to your new Assets file. Now, if you made your resource pack the way that I show in my previous video, then you should already have that Lang folder sitting inside of there. Okay, there we go. That takes care of that part of it. Now we need to re-zip all this stuff together, the Assets folder, and the pack.mc meta file and the pack.png icon file. Right click and I'll use 7-zip. Come down to add to archive and give it a name. I'll call this one music disc 5 and make sure that your archive format right here is the zip format. Choose OK. It will then zip that file up. Once that's done, we can then add that over into Minecraft, and then everything should be working out perfectly for us. This actually goes very, very fast. It's slow at the beginning, then it picks up pace very quickly to compress this whole thing into that new zip file. And there we go, right there. Okay, now we can go back into Minecraft and put this into the resource folder. Here's Minecraft again. I'm just going to bring it down a bit in size, like that. Click on Options, click on Resource Packs. Open resource pack folder. There it is. Let's grab this music disc 5 file. Actually, I'm going to right drag that and choose copy. There we go. And minimize those out of the way. Click on done. Click on done again. Go back to options, back to resource packs. And you should now see that new resource pack right here. There it is. Click on the icon, that loads that in as your top resource pack. Choose Done. That then relaunches Minecraft with that resource pack. Choose Done again, and we're all set. Okay, let's go ahead now and go back to the game. Let's just get those two disks out of the way. There we are. And then let's take a look at the inventory here. So there's the purple disk. You can see now it says Dusty Road. That's why we did that one change right there. So it has the right name on it. And we're on that disk. There it is. It just says music disk here. But in the inventory, it now says Dusty Road. So that is perfect. Let's go ahead and try this out. And there it is. There's our new song playing. Let's now make sure that it fades out. I'll just walk backwards in here. Have to go back a little ways before it begins to fade out. And beginning to fade out now. And there it goes. It's just beginning to go away. So a fade out is working perfectly as well. Okay. So there it is. That's how to easily set up a custom sound on one of your music discs. You can then play those inside of the jukebox. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. Consider supporting my channel through Patreon. Don't forget to subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every week. About half of those right now on Minecraft and about half on graphics programs, Photoshop, and Photoshop Elements. And if you want to learn more about graphics programs, take a look at my complete training courses, and there's links for that right down there in the description.